finances is another area of it, of concern, right? Because sometimes when you've had to leave work, or maybe you don't have third-party insurance or life insurance, or it's sometimes difficult to access disability benefits, and those disability benefits aren't always enough to live off, or in the way that you were living off of a salary or a wage before. Those are things that really make this whole situation harder. Not to say that the health issues aren't hard enough already, but sometimes when you add financial stress on top of living with an advanced illness, then it just makes everything more intense and increases the pressure on someone and their family and their loved ones and the people that they support. So I think sometimes even just talking to a social worker or a counselor about that can really help. Again, not because it's going to all of a sudden make money grow on trees, but sometimes just making sure that you're managing as well as you can. And you might not have a lot in the way of savings. You might not have, you might not have anyone that you can turn to when you do run out of money, right? And so it's really, really challenging to navigate that. And it's different for everybody. And people of all ages can deal with financial stress, for sure. But I think sometimes because AYAs are often just beginning their career, or they're still in school, or they've racked up a ton of student debt, you know, like it's really, really challenging.